This video has been made possible by our sponsor Squarespace. Whether you need a domain, website or online store, make your next move with Squarespace. Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creating Process. Today we're going to be working on another graphic design concept. In this, we're going to be creating a motion blur waves that can be applied to any objects in motion. It has got a very interesting effect. We have created this effect using Illustrator and Photoshop. It was quite a challenging design to create, but we have found a technique which can be followed to create out these kinds of concepts. So let's begin with designing process. First, we're going to be creating the waves using the blend options. So open a new Illustrator document. Then select the rectangle tool and draw out a rectangle same size of the artboard. It will be used as a background, so apply a fill color. Choose dark purple color using the color picker and click OK. Then use the shortcut Command or Control 2 to lock the shape. Next, to create the wave curves, select the pen tool and start drawing out a wave. Click and drag to give a smooth curves. Switch the fill color to stroke color to give a stroke thickness. Then double click on the stroke color and choose white color. Now continue drawing the curves in a single path. Once you complete creating the wave curve path, we'll give a gradient color to the stroke. So using the selection tool, click on the gradient icon. This will apply the gradient color to the stroke. Now choose a gradient color from the gradient panel. Here you'll find few gradient color shades. Let's choose this orange one. Now we'll do further adjustments with the gradient slider. We'll edit each of the sliders as per our requirement. Double click on the first slider and pick a purple color. For the second slider, pick dark magenta color. And for the last slider, pick magenta color. Now we'll add few more sliders to give shades and highlights. Click here to add a slider on the left side. For this, we'll give a bright color. So choose HSB option. Here, increase the brightness by adjusting the sliders. Let's increase the thickness of the stroke to see the changes. Select the third slider and make it little darker. Add one more slider and give it a bright magenta color. This way, we'll add bright color to give highlights and dark color to give depth. Once you're done with the gradient adjustments, reduce the stroke thickness to 1 point. Now, create a duplicate of the stroke with the Alt pressed. Then, selecting both the strokes, select Blend tool from the toolbar. First, click on the first curve. Then, click on the second curve. This will create a blend steps. Now, double click on the Blend tool to open the attribute panel. Here, choose Specify steps and increase the steps to around 50. And click OK. To increase the stroke thickness a little bit more, double click on the blend option, then select each of the curves and change the stroke thickness to 2 point. Now here we'll do little more adjustments with the gradient color to give a nice look to the design. After that, select the die selection tool and edit the anchor points. To change the direction of the corner points, use the anchor point tool and click and drag to give a curve angle. Do the same for the other corner as well. Now using the die selection tool, start modifying the shape of the lower curves. We're trying to give a random shape to the design. It will add an interesting flow to the blend curves. Adjust the handles to maintain the flow. After this, let's do little adjustments with the glossiness color. Under gradient, change it to light blue color. Next, select a design and go to Object, Expand, and under Expand panel, make sure that all the options are ticked and click OK. This will convert all the steps to individual strokes. After this, let's modify the shape of the design. So go to Object, Envelope Distort, and choose Make with Mesh. Here, set the rows and columns to 4x4 and click OK. This will add a mesh division to the design. Now, using the die selection tool, you can adjust the flow of the wave. tweak each of the anchor points to give a dynamic structure. Adjust the handles to change the direction. This step will decide the look of your design. After you have completed the modification, go to Object and expand the shape. This will again convert the mesh shape to strokes, but this will add lots of anchor points. So to reduce the number of points, go to Object, Path and click on Simplify. On the Simplify attribute panel, set the curve precision value to around 69% and click OK. This way, you got the wavy curves with a minimum number of anchor points. Next, select few of the curves from the middle and give it a different color. We'll use these stroke curves to create the white glossy stroke effect. So first, select the alternate curves and delete it out. Then again, from the remaining blue curves, select the alternate ones and increase its stroke thickness to 4 points. We'll apply gradient color to this. On the gradient panel, adjust each of the sliders to make the colors brighter. Double click on each of the sliders to open the attributes and adjust it to make the colors brighter. Once you are done with the adjustments, select the remaining blue curves and pick the gradient color from the previous curves using the eyedropper tool. Now we'll give a glow to the thick strokes. So select them and go to Effect, Blur, Gaussian Blur. Set the radius value to around 1.4 pixel and click OK. This will give a soft look to the curves. Now again go to Effect, Stylize and apply Auto Glow. Change the glow color to light pink. Reduce the blur value to 2 points and opacity to 75% and click OK. This way, we are done with the vector curve design adjustments. Next, we'll go to Photoshop and create the motion blur effect. Apply dark purple color as a background. Now select a design and drag and drop it to a Photoshop document. Now selecting the layer, go to Filter, Blur Gallery and apply Tilt Shift. Place the center points at the beginning and rotate the angle diagonally. Increase the blur region by adjusting the lines. Set the blur value around 4 and click OK. This will add a nice depth of field. Next, add a new hue and saturation adjustment layer and clip it to the vector layer with the Alt pressed. Then increase the saturation value to increase the color intensity. After this, create one more duplicate of the vector smart layer. We'll use this to add more wavy layers. Change the blend mode to color dodge and push it upward. We'll create one more duplicate of the smart layer. This one, we'll drag it down. Change the blend mode to screen and reduce its fill value to around 34%. Select the previous layer and reduce its fill value to 52%. Next, we'll modify the shape of the duplicated layers using the wrap option. But before that, we'll convert the layers to smart object. Right click and choose convert to smart object. Now, using the command or control T, activate transform option. Then right click and choose wrap option. Adjust the handles to modify the shape. Click and drag the left edge closer to our main design. Then press enter. We'll do the same steps to the second layer. Convert it into a smart object. Then right click and activate wrap option. Drag the lower edge up to merge it with the main design. This way we are giving an illusion as if the waves are originating from the single point. Then press enter. Next, create one more duplicate of the main layer. Click and drag it to the new layer icon. Place this layer on top and change the blend mode to color dodge. This will add a bright glow to the design. Reduce the fill value to around 65%. Now, let's do little adjustments with the blur value. So, double click on the blur gallery. This will open the tilt shift attribute option. Here, let's increase the blur value to 9 points. And click OK. This will add a nice soft blur to the glow. Now we'll drag in a running image of an athlete. You can use any objects which is in motion. Place it on top of the layer. Let's flip the image direction and place it at the beginning of the wave. Do some adjustment with the rotation and the position to match it with the flow of the motion blur. Now we'll match the color of the image with the design theme. So add a new hue and saturation adjustment layer. Clip it to our image layer. Just press the Alt key and when you see this icon, click on it and the adjustment layer is clipped. Now go to attributes and increase the hue value until you get this nice purple matching color. Also, adjust the saturation value to match the color intensity. After this, add a curve adjustment layer and clip it to the image layer. Now under the attribute panel, select the blue option and adjust the curve. Then adjust the green curves and the red curves to blend it with our design. Next, we'll add tilt shift blur to the image. So select the option under blur gallery. Place it over the body. Set the angle diagonally and adjust the blur range. Set the blur value to around 2 points and click OK. This will add a nice soft blur to the hand and add a focus to the face. Now drag the color dodge layer on top. Convert it into smart object. Then using the wrap option, start adjusting the shape of the wave curves. Place the origin of the curve over the shoulder and the lower curves over the hip. Once you are done with the adjustments, press enter. Next, add a brightness and contrast adjustment layer on top. Set the contrast value to 7. And the brightness value to 4. This will add a nice contrast to the overall design. Now, let's add a spotlight on the background. So, add a new layer just above the background layer. Change the blend mode to color dodge. Now, select the brush tool, increase the brush size, and choose a soft brush. Pick the magenta color from the design using the eyedropper tool. Then apply a spot on the lower right corner. Now pick under color from the color picker, choose purple color, increase the brush size and apply it on top left corner. This will add a nice effect to the design. Now if you look closer to the image, you can see a sharp edges. Let's fix it. So select the layer, then with the control pressed, click on the thumbnail. This will make a selection. Click on the mask option to apply layer mask. Next, under properties option, click on mask edge. Here, set the smooth value to 32, feather to 1 pixel, shift edge to -22% and click OK. This will give us an image with a soft edge. Lastly, type our text, speed, scale up the size and increase the spacing between each of the alphabet. To give a slight tilt to the text, activate the transform option and choose skew option. Then drag the top edge to give a tilt angle to the text. And finally, we have completed designing a concept of motion blur wavy effect using Illustrator and Photoshop. We have used some new techniques while creating out this design. Now you know how to create an illustration with motion blur. Also, I'd like to thank Squarespace for supporting the channel. It's an all-in-one platform where you can go and create a beautiful website. They have got this really easy to use platform. They have got designer's template, domains and really good customer service 24/7. You can easily open online stores that allow you to manage your products, orders and inventory easily. If you want to try it out, go to squarespace.com/createandprocess to save 10% off your first purchase. Highly recommended. Make your business stand out with Squarespace. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.